morning. My name is Alexander Diaz. And I'll be presenting to you all Foot Tennis Premier League, or the FTPL. So what is the FTPL? It's an ultimate combination between soccer and tennis. For me, personally, when I was a kid, I played a lot of soccer, and sometimes I used to play with my friends before training, and we started playing foot tennis. For us, at the beginning, we thought we invented this, and we were so excited about this. After, like, when we grew up, we noticed that this was a worldwide thing, and it's been played everywhere that a ball has been kicked to a goal. This is the opportunity to show who is the best at foot tennis. Usually you play with your friends just for fun, so this is the real opportunity to figure out who's actually the best player in this discipline. For me, you know, it's all about let's just have fun. As I said, it's just remembering when I was a kid and when we were playing with my friends, so I just want to bring that out on people. And you know, it's a competition, but again, it's not like soccer that's really, really intense. It's more of a side game that we can have fun and have a couple of laughs. To start, I'll be charging $50 per competitor, and I picked June 3rd, 2016 because of a really special event that I'll be mentioning throughout the presentation. So to be clear, and you all know what foot tennis is, I wanted to explain to you first the rules. We're gonna have teams of two and teams of three, and they all have three touches per team, one touch per person, and a player cannot touch the ball two times consecutively. The team will be allowed one bounce before passing the ball towards the other team's court, and right now I'll show you an example so it's more clear. So this is how it's played. As you see, this is the national Argentinian team playing foot tennis during a practice. So you can see that it's played, you know, from amateur level as I was to a more professional level. As you see, they have three touches. They all touch it once, and they let the ball bounce before touching it again. And of course, to score a point, you have to make the opposition team throw it outside of your court.
Jeez.
How long is that video?
It's a video, a 1 minute.
Right, that was 1 point. Can anybody score?
Oh yeah, no, that was 1 point, but of course there are professionals. Like you saw the ball went all the way there and they still got it back. No, usually a point of this would be around like 30 seconds or more. Like probably you get four times to pass it back and forth. I mean, I'm talking about us level normal people. These guys are, you know, you were seeing Messi and Di Maria play. They're players that make $15 million euros a year to play sports. So of course there's technical differences from them. So how this event will work? Again, we'll have two categories. We'll feature doubles and triples. We're expecting 32 teams per category. That makes a total of 160 competitors. We're gonna do it as the World Cup structure. So we're gonna have 8 groups and four teams in each group. That will allow each team to play at least 3 games before being disqualified. Of course, the first 2 teams in each group go on to the knockout stage, and then the knockout stage will be just a single game. If you lose, then sadly you'll go home. If you win, then you can advance to the next stage of the FTPL. So, for my industry analysis, as you can all imagine, this is a discipline that is not as popular as you would say soccer and tennis. So I looked a little bit more in the soccer industry here in South Florida, and I saw that it's been growing humongous, with non-stop. Every year they implement more teams and more people and more money toward this sport. So it's a good place to invest in soccer. As you all know, there's an MLS team coming up in the next 2 years. So it's bringing a lot of excitement in Miami and a lot of wanting for for soccer and this sport. As well, there's also the FIFTA, which is the official FIFA for foot tennis. And this organization was founded in 1987. So far, it has hosted 11 World Cup tournaments. Nevertheless, these tournaments have only involved European countries because of their logistics. So I want to bring the FIFTA here to North and South America, at least. They've been, as I said, they've been hosting tournaments since 1994, but never here in this side of the sea. So I wanted to be the first one to actually bring this here. The tournament that I was mentioning before, because why we picked June 3rd, is the Copa America Centenario. As you all know, for the first time in history, they're gonna play the Copa America here in the United States. So it's a big thing for the States, bringing such an important worldwide tournament to their land. So I decided to do the event the same day as the Copa America would start, because I thought there would be a lot of people excited about this, since, you know, there's a worldwide recognized tournament that's about to start for a month long. So nevertheless, the FTPO will not interfere with the Copa America game, since it would start at 9 the game, and our tournament will be over around 6 p.m. So for potential competitors, as I said, there's no direct competitors for this industry. Nevertheless, we do have some indirect competitors that we should take a look. For example, soccer camps, summer league, preseason camps, skill challenge, another like 5v5 and 7v7 tournaments. I think there would be a indirect competitors towards my tournament, because players might be already committed to these camps or these teams, so they might not have the chance or the time to take a look at my tournament. However, because of this, I decided to only host the FTPL for one day for 6 hours. So if you were already committed towards another team or another training camp, because as we all know, athletes usually get on preseason camps to be ready for the season upcoming, they can attend. And I took a look, and most of the summer leagues and summer camps charge over $100 per competitor, at least 100, 150, even for 400, depending on what's offered for them. Mine is only worth $50, so I believe it's a good opportunity for athletes to, you know, come and blow some steam off. So where is the FTPO gonna happen? So Doral, Florida, June 3rd. As you can see here, this is a sports complex that it's gonna be held at. How to get there? I'm gonna be targeting four main targets, and of course, when the competitors sign in to my event, we'll send them the map of their location to our location, as I'm gonna show here. Boca Raton will be one of our target locations. It's just a 40-minute drive down to Miami, and the turnpike is available, so it's a faster route. Downtown Miami, 30 minutes with turnpike available as well, such as Kendall, which is just a 20-minute drive, and Aventura, which is a 40-minute drive. As you can see here, the spectator map, we're gonna have the smaller field for us, and we're gonna construct eight small courts in that soccer field. Here's a spectator map where you can see where we're gonna be located, and the tents of the athletes, such as the emergency exit and the medical aid. Moving on, for my staff and HR, the FTPL will have 33 employees. Out of them, 10 would be paid employees. The structure would be the CEO, the event manager, which of course would be me, the brains of the association. And the next in line following me would be my site manager. For the FTPL, this is a really important position, because the site manager will be in charge of the venue that same day. So if anything goes wrong or anything is misplaced, the site manager will be on top of that and 100% focused on that situation. The next The next down the line is the sponsor manager and the event and guest staff manager. For my sponsor manager, for me this is really important because sponsors are a key factor for the FTPL. So I decided to bring one staff that can help me with that since it's really important. The sponsor manager would be in charge of supervising all the sponsor paperwork and make sure all the paperwork is on track, everything is fine, the sponsors are happy, so as the FTPL, and anything that they would like to add or they don't like from the FTPL, the sponsor manager would be communicating with them so they can, everything would be in charge and synchronized to everybody's one. Furthermore, I explained the staff and human resources. As I said, there are going to be paid positions. The site manager, as I explained, will be charged $50, $50 for the event plus $10 per hour on working that event. The sponsor manager will be paid $50 as a flat rate because there's no need for the sponsor manager to be on site during that event because their work is more in the back doors of the FTPL. And main referees would, of course, be paid 8.5 per hour. To determine the referees, we'll be needing 24 referees for the competition. It's gonna be 3 per field and 1 main referee. To decide who's gonna be the main referees, we're gonna be targeting college students that are usually looking to get some money because of tight schedules. We're gonna interview them and we'll determine in the interview who is qualified to fill the main referee position or the sideline position, which is a non-paid position. Of course, the main referee would be the one who knows more about soccer and understands and have a clear understanding of the foot tennis rules. So this would be my player's waiver in case of any injury or accident. And I would also have a staff waiver since my staff will be involved in the field and I don't want them to get hurt. You never know if a ball comes towards them or an accident, you know, better safe than sorry. So moving on to my marketing part of the FTPL, we decided to target people from the age of 16 to the age of 35. And for this opportunity, we will only be targeting men since this is a men-only competition for the first time. We'll see how it grows and how it develops. So, as I said before, we'll be targeting locations such as Miami, Doral, Boca Raton, Aventura, Pembroke Pines, Kendall, and looking for people that are interested in soccer, in competing, on being a team player since this is only a sport that can be played as a team. So, in order to connect with this demographic, I decided to use 4 marketing strategies: flyers, Facebook banners, websites banners, and magazines ad. So, in order to communicate with my demographic, I put out the flyer, which, as you said, says, tired from running all the field, as usually you know, soccer players are always tired from playing. This is an opportunity to just run around a square that's not so high demanding and still you can practice your soccer skills. So I thought it would be a great kind of funny thing to put there so I can catch their attention. I also put the website, which I already checked, and it's the FTPL, it's available. It's not in use. I also put my phone number so they can contact me if they would have any questions regarding the event. So on, to keep the paper advertisement, I also added a magazine ad. Now, for this magazine ad, I decided to do it in Spanish because there's a lot of Hispanic people in Miami. To be precise, there's more than 250,000 Hispanic people in South Florida. So I thought it would be a great opportunity to try to directly approach them. As you said, it says you want to have fun, sign on to the FTPL and win prizes by doing what you like. If You see, there's a combination between soccer and tennis, which is self-explanatory, and it shows the people what this event consists on. Following up, there will be the Facebook ad. It says, if Messi plays, why not you? You know, I thought of it kind of a funny challenge to see, you know, the best player in soccer playing that and saying, hey, if he plays it, then I should give it a try, right? I mean, if the guy who is the best in this sport is doing that, let's see if I can have some luck as well. So, of course, I put my website so they can communicate with me, and I mentioned that it's in Miami for the first time, so people get hyped about it. For the website ad, I put a tennis court and a bunch of soccer balls, and I put, we need you to kick some balls. I thought it would be kind of funny, you know, get people's attention and come try out our tournament. Again, I put my website so they know what it is. The website is the only way of signing in and joining my tournament, so I decided to put it in all of my advertisements so they know where to sign up. Moving on, for my sponsorship packages, I developed three sponsorship packages. The first one is the event sponsor. It will be worth $6,000, and it will provide them with four sideline banners between fields, logo, and the website link on our website. The logo will be featured in all the event flyers as well. So with all the flyers, the company's logo will be on our flyers, sorry. And of course, we'll give them recognition during the whole event. We will mention them and thank them during the whole event multiple times so people know that they are the reason why this is going on. For a gold sponsor, it would be worth $2,500. It would only give them two sideline banners in the fields, and it will put their company logo on the flyers, but they would have no recognition on our website. And again, our website is the most visited thing of our organization, so it's really important. And of course, we'll give them recognition during the award ceremony, you know, thank them for helping us out and for making this possible. Our last sponsorship package is the match ball sponsor. This will be worth $1,000. It will give the company the opportunity of placing their logo and their information on the official game ball. The FTPL decided to use the Nike as a potential sponsor. I'll explain it afterwards. So, if we do get Nike as a potential sponsor, this will be the official ball, which is the ball of the Copa America, which is the tournament that's gonna be played the same day as our tournament. So it gives more excitement and more hype about the whole event and the whole bringing soccer to America. So for our potential sponsors in the different packages, I decided to put Soccer Locker, Mad About Soccer, Dick's Sporting Good, La Canchita, and Nike, which are all soccer businesses located in South Florida, more towards Miami, because I thought they would have an interest of bringing, of advertising my tournament. For gold sponsors, I used pretty much similar companies for my event sponsor, since I think they fit into the same category. And for my ball sponsor, I added Adidas, Nike, Portafield, ProDirect, Soccer Locker, and What About Soccer, which are all equipment stores that can actually sell us all the equipment that we need for our tournament. So in terms of our growth analysis, we hope to bring the FTPL all around South Florida and host multiple tournaments a year. We will use all money that has been collected this tournament to use it for the up and coming tournaments and to have a better budget. We also hope to expand, as I said, to different places of South Florida, such as Tampa, Orlando, Jacksonville, which are places that have soccer fan demographic. And last but not least, we hope to host an FTPL Champions Only tournament. Eventually, if we have several tournaments going on, we can invite all the winners from each tournament and host an ultimate FTPL with a really, really good foot tennis level. To finish up, I would like to explain to you all my budgeting. So participation fees will be $8,000, as I said, $50 per competitor. The event sponsor is $6,000, gold sponsor $2,500, and $1,000 equals $17,500. For my operating expenses, I would have to buy the court lines to make my courts, right? So people know what are the limits of the court. I would have to buy this rope since we're playing in turf. We cannot just paint over the turf, of course. Soccer balls, our website, the field rent, the nets, publicity banners, our flyers, our trophies. We'll be given one trophy for all competitors. So all the members in the team will get one trophy. It will not be one trophy per team, but they all get one, so they can all bring home back something to remember. And our employees, which the cost will be 432, summing up for 349, and when subtracted, we get our revenue of $4,051. So, are you ready for the FTPL? Sign up now in the FTPL.com.